I made a few refinements to the layout so that I could get things to fit. So I adjusted the size and position of the pizza and the logo, the specialty pizza subhead, and I adjusted the size of the text frame. I also made a duplicate copy of pizza to place down in, among the text. And what I did here was two objects. I've got the pizza itself, and then I've got a circle object. And the circle object has a wraparound on it so that the text will wrap around. And I just have placed that circle object above the illustration. So if I move this, you could see that the text is just going to wrap around that circle object. So for your illustrations, you could do something similar. And if you have an irregular shape, you know, mine is a circle, so I was able to just go to the ellipse tool and create a circle. But if you have an irregular shape, you could actually take the pen tool and you could draw an irregular shape that would convert your illustration. And then you can go to object strap and then make object. And there are some options here. You can adjust the distance that the text is wrapping from the, you would go into text wrap options, and you can make adjustments there. So that's called an offset, and this is 6 points. So, you know, we could do something to a pre, let's try just to make it real obvious. Let's try. Okay, so you, all right, so I'm just going to put my circle back. And there it is. All right, so the top of the pizza. Another thing I did is I changed the to give it some negative tracking so that the spacing was a little bit tighter. This price under fresh veggie on one line, otherwise the illustration was bumped. My prices paragraph style, went to the options, and then I put negative 20 tracking on it. Originally it was okay. And another thing that we could do is we could put a thin black vertical rule columns a little bit better in a visual way. So I'm just going to take the line rule and I'm going to hold the shift key and click and drag. I'm going to make that very thin stroke. Okay, and that's really all I want. I don't want it to be, for my layout anyway, I don't want this to be a really prominent element. I just want it to be a subtle visual separation. It just helps with readability a little bit. It looks a little bit more refined if we add some details like that. Paste in place, and then I'm going to drag the copy down here. And holding shift, I'm just going to adjust the size of that. All right, so looking pretty much finished. One thing I would like to show you, though, is some prices in kind of a list format using tabs, which is a really common way in a single line. And I've got these little vertical divisions. There's a key that you can use on your keyboard to create these. It's under the delete key on the Mac anyway. To hit return on these. I'm actually going to create a new style. So let me prices tab. And I'm going to change the paragraph space. Let's see, the paragraph, make that, let's try 8. There we go. Okay, that looks better. And actually, so let me go back there again. Let's try bold. And 10 point. Okay. Okay, so, and go to the type menu. Actually, I'm going to the window, type, and then choose tabs, and then there's a keyboard shortcut for that. And it brings up a little ruler. And these little symbols are showing the justification of the tab on the left, and we'll keep this left justification. And I want that indented. Let's try an inch and see how that looks. All right, and then if I click in front of my first item and then the second and hit the tab key, it's going to bump it over. Let's try to move this. That might be a little bit too far. Now, all right, let's see. And let's get rid of that one. Okay, and then the key is you've got to select all of the items if you want them all to align. And then if I was to, let's try to move, okay, they all follow along. So if you want to delete a tab, you just click and drag it away from the ruler and it'll disappear, it'll delete. If you want to move it, you click and just drag it along this ruler wherever you want this to be positioned. So that is about right. I mean, this is just menu if you want to use this kind of formatting. Let's make a tab on the right. What I'm going to do is I'm going to click someplace to the right of the first tab. Let's try about here. Justified right. So I'm going to click on the justified right tab and it's going to convert the current tab to justified right. And then what we can do is we can hit the tab key right and it's going to bump over to that tab that we set. All right, another thing I'd like to do, so, you know, what goes with what, especially it's kind of easy to figure out if it's just a list of three like I have, kind of hard to have your eye follow across this big gap to the correct number. So let's select all these again. A leader is just some little filler dots that we can use. So I'm just typing them and it creates this little row of dots. Now to make this lead, we could make it a dash. All right, and I'm going to just adjust the position of this right hand one a little bit. Oops. Just be careful not to pull that away because you'll delete that tab. So I did not let go of the mouse button. Ruler, it's going to retain it. But if you were to drag it away and then just let go of the mouse button, it's going to disappear. So just be careful. Another thing you could do is you could do a few refinements here. So let's zoom in so you can see a little better. Do a couple of manual refinements. Like these leaders do not need to be so prominent. They're not that open. I can close, I don't need this tab window anymore, so I can just, and then instead of this being bold, why don't we make it regular? And then we can even make the point size smaller. Let's try 10. Maybe that looks better. These really are just to guide your eye from left to right. They're not something that need to be that, this bold. And I'm just going to copy. Paste it into the other ones. So I'm just doing this manually. All right, menu. And again, this is something that you can use just to as a guide for your own